what's behind our unhealthy behaviors. We sometimes succumb to unhealthy behaviors where we may overeat, oversleep, oversurf on the net. When we thus do some things that we know we shouldn't do, we often respond by rationalizing and justifying, saying that actually everyone does such things nowadays. Or we might beat ourselves up for being so morally corrupted. But that only makes us feel bad without making anything better. Either way, we relapse into those indulgences, and often to worse degrees. Why worse degrees? Because we are dragged by our desires. The Bhagavad Gita states in 16:12, Asha Pashishatair Baddha Kama Krodha Parayanaha Ihante Kama Bhogarthan Anyayena Artha Sanchayan, that our desires become like shackles, Asha Pasha Shatair Baddha, and we are bound by hundreds and thousands of such desires. And Kama Krodha Parayanaha, we become sold to lust and anger, and then craving those pleasures, Ihante Kama Bhogartham Anyayena Artha Sanchayan. We seek wealth by unfair means. We act unfairly. So though we might normally be kind and gentle, when we are blinded by our pursuit for pleasures, we might become mean, and we might act in ways that are mean and cruel. We may well do things that we would never do normally. How can we prevent? How can we ensure that we don't become mean? For that, we need to understand what our unhealthy behaviors mean. What is actually causing them? Sometimes the cause might just be impurities such as lust or greed. More often, however, those impurities are able to control us because we have been rendered vulnerable because of some deeper wounds, because of some emotional wounds. Someone might have betrayed us and we have simmering anger burning within us. Someone might have trumped us in our career where we had invested our whole heart, and we might now be feeling purposeless. When the pain of these deeper wounds is difficult for us to bear or cure, then we go toward unhealthy indulgences as painkillers. If we go deep into our psyche, then we'll understand what is making us do such things. And for going deep into our psyche, Gita wisdom can help us with its explanation of the major players in our inner world. Further, by helping us appreciate that we are indestructible souls, it can give us the security and maturity to address those wounds maturely. And by practicing processes such as Bhakti Yoga, we can free ourselves from the impurities that impel us towards those behaviors. By thus addressing both the impurities that impel unhealthy behaviors and the wounds that make us vulnerable to those impurities, we can heal ourselves holistically. The more we understand what our unhealthy behaviors mean and address them meaningfully, the further we go from the path that might make us mean. Thank you.